Hi, welcome to Stress Free Cooking. I'm Barbara Selig Brown. This is Tom Beyer. We love to cook together. And today on Stress Free Cooking, we're going to take you for a little tour of the Mediterranean. We all know that the Mediterranean diet is a healthy diet. And since we focus on developing healthy recipes, we're going to talk about Mediterranean food. The first thing that we're going to do is get our eggplants ready for a baked eggplant that we're going to top with a tomato basil mixture. So to do that, we have to get these into the oven early in the show. So we're going to cut those in half lengthwise. Perfect. And eggplant is like a sponge. So what I like to do when my eggplant is cut is I like to put a little salt or salt and pepper on it. It'll bring the moisture to the surface of the eggplant and it will absorb a lot less oil. Okay, so we're gonna get this ready. Let this sit for a minute or two. Let the moisture come to the surface. Then I'm gonna drizzle it with extra virgin olive oil and we'll put it in the oven. But in the meantime, we're gonna start our featured recipe, which is our Mediterranean vegetable stew with chickpeas. So Tom, to start this, we need some crushed garlic. Okay. And we need a nice big soup pan or saucepan, some extra virgin olive oil. And then we'll start by putting our garlic into the oil and letting it saute a little bit. And once the garlic becomes fragrant, we can begin adding our other ingredients. So the ingredients for this dish today are going to be some diced tomatoes, some chickpeas. A very important part of the Mediterranean diet is grains or legumes. We have some eggplant, and you'll notice we have a white eggplant and we have a purple eggplant. Eggplant comes in many varieties. Sometimes you'll see pink, sometimes you'll see purple, sometimes you'll see a pink and white stripe. Generally, they're all about the same. It's just the outside that looks different, but I find the white is usually the sweetest. So that garlic is perfect.
Yes.
We crushed it with a chef's knife, took the skin off, and gave it a rough chop. And the next thing we need to do is cut up our eggplant, because again, we have to let the eggplant sit with a little bit of salt on it so that it brings the moisture to the surface. And we have a nice bowl here. In case you're short on counter space, you can use a bowl and you can put all of your waste in that bowl. Okay, so we're gonna quarter that and then we're gonna cut it into bite-sized pieces because this is a stew that we want some heft to, some mouthfeel to, but we also still want it to be bite-sized and spoonable. Okay? So a little bigger, good, perfect. And we're gonna throw those into this bowl so that I can salt them and toss them around a little. So we'll start this out. And we really don't need to add any additional salt to this dish because we're already salting our eggplant. So that likely will have enough salt on it. Once the moisture on these starts to come to the surface, I'm gonna start adding them to my big pan. I love this pan. It's called a pasta pan, literally, because you make your pasta sauce in this pan and then you boil your pasta separately and add it to this, and that way you can blend your pasta sauce and your pasta together. We need both of those eggplants, okay. Please. Okay, and the garlic is beginning to smell beautiful. And we want to be careful when we're cooking with garlic that we don't burn the garlic. So we want to keep our eye on it. Once it becomes fragrant, you want to really pay attention to it. We don't want it to get black. Cake Bread Cellars was founded in 1973 by Jack and Dolores Cake Bread. Now the second generation of Cake Breads are running the winery. Cake Bread has been known for its unparalleled wines and its gracious hospitality.
Mainly in the Napa Valley and the North Coast, you can visit the winery or watch for Cake Bread events in your area. With an enduring commitment to quality, the belief that life's occasions are elevated by good people, good food, and good wine flows through everything they do.
The Cake Breads take great pride in sharing their family with our families. Throw that right in here. And this eggplant is already beginning to become a little bit watery, which is exactly what I want. So I'm gonna check this one, which is also perfect. And I'll add my extra virgin olive oil to this one, just a drizzle, because this is gonna go into my oven and get soft. So we'll pop this in the oven. And if you wouldn't mind cutting that zucchini.
Zucchini also.
Okay, I'm gonna start adding my eggplant to my garlic and olive oil. Once I add other ingredients to my pan, the garlic will stop getting too brown because the other ingredients will take some of the heat away. We could also use a yellow zucchini, a golden zucchini, a yellow squash. Anything in that same family would be just fine. We have some fresh basil leaves that we'll give a rough chop to. And we also have a bell pepper. I like to add color. And so we're gonna add some yellow bell pepper to this. Any bell pepper will work. But in this dish today, we've got green, we've got purple, we've got red, we've got this beige from the chickpeas. So I thought the yellow would be a nice complement. Those are great knife skills.
I'm learning.
You do great, okay? So right into here, okay? This goes together really quick. It only has to cook maybe 20, 30 minutes after everything's in the pan so that everything becomes tender, and really that's it. It'll come together nicely. So for bell peppers, we always cut it as if it had four sides, as if it were a square. So you cut off each section. And then we can shake out the seeds. Beautiful. And then we're gonna cut that into bite-sized pieces, so not too small. And you can see how much extra virgin olive oil the ingredients have absorbed already because they're both very porous. So while Tom's cutting the pepper, I'm gonna add some of my Italian seasoning blend. You can find the recipe for this on my website, stressfreecooking.com. Add it to the pan surface so that the seasonings or spices in this actually get toasted a little bit. If they get toasted, they're gonna be much more flavorful than if we just put them on top of everything. So that's an important little tip, is to toast your seasonings and get the most out of them. Looks good. Throw those in here. And once we have the bell pepper in here, we can add the chickpeas and the bay leaves, and the final thing we'll add will be our tomato. So we want to give these basil leaves just a nice rough chop when you have a moment. It's really fun to cook together, don't you think, Tom?
It is.
It makes the cooking go more quickly.
It does. I'm learning so much, too, you know.
It also makes the cleanup go easier.
Yes.
And if you cook with wine...
You drink wine while you cook.
It's more fun because you have some for the cook and some for the pot, right? Right?
Exactly.
I heard a joke once that some people cook with wine and they even add it to the pot.
Yes.
Would that be you?
That would be us. Not me, us.
Us. Okay. So those basil leaves are going to go in here when you're ready. Now the chickpeas you can buy fresh and cryovac. You can buy them in a can, but however you buy them, make sure that you rinse them and drain them. That way you get rid of all of the any additives that were in the processing of the chickpeas. And also, it helps you to get rid of some of the gassiness that comes from beans and grains. So once I have this well mixed, I will add the tomatoes. And then we're just gonna let this cook for about 20 or 30 minutes. We'll go back to our eggplant. So get those tomatoes in here. And this was a 28-ounce can of good quality diced tomatoes. It's gonna give us the moisture for our stew.
Okay. This would be total vegetarian, yes?
This is total vegetarian. There's nothing in here but vegetables and the chickpeas,
vegan?
Extra virgin olive oil.
Vegan also?
Yes, it would be vegan as well, although we do know a vegan who won't eat extra virgin olive oil, but extra virgin olive oil is a plant product, so there may be other reasons for not using extra virgin olive oil in a vegan dish, but I think, you know, it is a vegan product. Okay, I'm gonna cover this, we're gonna clean up, and we're gonna go back to our second dish. Crave Brothers is a family-run business producing award-winning mozzarella and many other farmstead cheeses.
Their mozzarella and marinated mozzarella are fresh and light, and their mascarpone is velvety smooth. They also produce cheddar cheese curds, which are great for snacking. Their cheese is green energy produced and made from fresh, high quality milk from their own dairy farm.
You can find their cheeses at www.cravecheese.com and many other national retailers. We're sure you'll enjoy these cheeses as much as we do. While our stew is cooking, let's work on our second dish.
Okay.
So we have our eggplant in the oven roasting. We're gonna make a topping for that. So our topping ingredients are going to be a plum tomato, about half of a yellow bell pepper, because we're not making a huge quantity.
It's a small eggplant.
And again, we're thinking about color, right? So we could use any color bell pepper,
right.
But the yellow and the red look great. We have fresh basil leaves, some fresh parsley, and we're gonna shred some mozzarella. So that's gonna all go together with extra virgin olive oil and balsamic vinegar. And when our roasted eggplant is done and it's fork tender, we'll pull it out of the oven, we'll put this topping on, and we'll just pop it back in the oven for a minute or two to just warm everything up.
Okay.
Okay? So Tom, I'm gonna let you start with your choice, basil.
Okay.
And why'd you pick the basil first?
Because it was closest to me.
Because the cutting board was nice and dry.
I mean, yes.
And the basil will chop better if it's dry and if the cutting board is nice and dry. So, and then we're just gonna put that into this bowl. And you know, our eggplant were very small, so we want our pieces to be maybe even just a little smaller than bite size for this dish. So they stay on top of the eggplant. And we won't need all of this parsley. When you're using fresh herbs, you're gonna wash them and dry them thoroughly. The drier they are, the better they will chop. And they'll, otherwise, if they're too wet, they're just gonna become mushy when you chop them. So you can see how dry and how light they are when they've been washed and dried properly.
Right.
Okay? So I guess you probably want the parsley next.
Parsley next.
We're using flat Italian parsley. Flat Italian parsley has a lot more flavor than curly parsley. Curly parsley was actually used at the turn of the 19th century for breath freshener when people didn't have all the great things we have now to keep our breath smelling wonderful.
How do you dry the herbs, Barbara?
Well, I wash them in a colander and I shake them off, and then I can wrap them in paper towel, or you could use a salad spinner, that will work.
Okay.
But I usually just lay them out on a paper towel, roll them up, and all the moisture will obviously go into the paper towel. And if I feel they're still wet, I'll do that a second time.
Okay.
And then when I store them, I put them in a plastic bag in my refrigerator. And parsley will keep several days. Basil, it's a little tricky. So you're better off keeping a basil plant on your kitchen counter, and you just take what you need when you need it. So we're gonna chop this plum tomato. And this plum tomato works well for this dish. We could also use very small cherry tomatoes, but cherry tomatoes cut in half could be a little big, and then it might be cumbersome to cut them even smaller. So in this dish, this plum tomato is gonna work better because it has a thick wall, it's very juicy, but it also has a very thin skin. Okay, and that looks great. Okay, and then we have our yellow bell pepper, or as I said, any bell pepper. Okay, I'm gonna add a pinch of our stress-free cooking seasoning blend. Maybe 2 pinches, that wasn't a very big pinch.
Big pinch.
Okay, and this is basil, parsley, oregano, rosemary, salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and it gives a nice flavor. And it's a shortcut for your kitchen.
Okay.
Looks great. So we have nice color here. We have red, yellow, green. I love colorful. I think it looks more appetizing, don't you? Okay. All right. So let me get rid of this for you.
Yes, for me, and I'm.
And then we're gonna shred our mozzarella cheese. So we have a microplane grater, and it's just a nice, quick, easy way to grate your cheese. Watch your knuckles.
I will.
And this will go in the dishwasher, and also, the colder your cheese is, the better.
Better it shreds. This is our Crave Brothers mozzarella,
which we love. One of our favorites, right?
Yes.
They make a really wonderful farmstead cheese, and it's always dependable. Okay, that might be enough. Let's take a peek. Let me stir this in. That's about a quarter of a cup. I actually could use another quarter cup, so about a half cup would do it. Okay, let's see. Perfect. You can have that piece to taste.
That's true. It's delicious.
Okay, I'm gonna check the oven.
Okay.
Let me wipe my hands. So our eggplant roasted beautifully. I'm gonna grab a fork and just make sure that this is fork tender. Yes, it is, perfect. So, we're gonna take some of our wonderful mixture. Once I add the extra virgin olive oil, and balsamic vinegar, just a little bit, just enough to bring it together. This could also be made a little bit ahead, and if the flavors sit and blend, even better. Okay, so here we have our topping for our eggplant. I need a spoon. So this topping on the eggplant. This would make a nice little appetizer. If you used large eggplant, you could serve this as an entree, a lunch, a brunch. Okay. And again, this is a vegetarian dish, but not vegan because we have our
cheese.
Mozzarella cheese, which definitely is an animal product. Okay, let's pop this back in the oven for a minute to melt our cheese and warm it up. Let's clean up and we'll come back
and taste.
And taste. Let's complete today's show, Tom, with your famous Caesar salad.
Okay.
Okay. So for Caesar salad, we want some washed and dried romaine, which we have right here. Romaine hearts work great because you get all the tender pieces. So how do we make Caesar salad dressing? Clove of garlic.
Clove of garlic.
We're gonna do it in our mini chopper. All you have to do now is crush that clove of garlic and throw it in your mini chopper.
Yep.
Okay? Mini chopper works great, especially for this, because we have so many things we have to puree or make very fine. Okay, so the clove of garlic in the mini chop. Next, we want some Worcestershire sauce.
Okay.
And some Dijon mustard. And this is a great example of how important it is to have all the ingredients actually laid out, because we get kidding around and then we'd forget where we were,
right? Exactly.
A pinch of salt and pepper.
Okay.
And lemon juice, and we're gonna save the Parmesan cheese for the salad. So we need a couple of those anchovies also after you're done with your lemon.
Okay.
And a great way to get the maximum lemon juice is bring the lemon to room temperature, roll it on the counter, and then we have this fork, which we can put inside the lemon. And we'll get all the juice out of it.
This is a very juicy lemon.
Good, good. And maybe we only need half of that, actually, since we're not making a huge amount of salad dressing. Okay. And we use the strainer so that we catch all the seeds in the strainer,
right,
and they don't go in our dressing.
Right.
Okay, a couple of anchovies.
Okay.
And some extra virgin olive oil.
How much of the anchovy?
Two.
Two.
We can always put the anchovies out on the table and let people add anchovies. Assemble our little mini chopper. Okay, and then we'll give it a taste. Let me grab a tasting spoon. We don't want to stick a finger in there. Okay, you tell me how it is. If it's your usual terrific.
It's good.
Good? Does it need anything else?
No.
Okay. All right, so our Caesar salad dressing. We'll go on our Caesar salad. We can go ahead and do that. And then we're gonna check our oven and we can taste the rest of our dishes.
Right.
Okay, so we'll toss this in just a second. Get every last drop of goodness. Let's check that eggplant. Oh, looks nice. Okay, I'm gonna move this Caesar salad. We need a little more room here. So let's take one of these and put it on our tasting plate. And that makes a nice appetizer size.
Yeah,
I could even cut these in half if I wanted to put them out, like at a cocktail party for people to nibble on. So would you like to have a taste?
I would.
Okay.
Terrific.
Can you taste all the different flavors in there?
All the different flavors, right.
Awesome. Okay, let's take a taste of our stew. So you can see how well these ingredients look together, and they also taste wonderful together. Now, you could sprinkle this with a little cheese.
Cheese if you liked.
If you like. Okay, this is a little hot, so let's let this cool and talk about what wine we would serve with these dishes.
Okay, we have chosen a cake bread Merlot. I got two glasses for our delicious cake bread Merlot.
Oh, and I love these big glasses for red wine because they really release the aromas and the bouquet of the red wine. That looks great. Look at the color of this. It's beautiful. It's really purpley, and you can tell. Just by looking at this, I'm gonna guess there's gonna be a lot of really good berry flavors in here. So let's give it a taste. Awesome.
That's wonderful.
There's a lot of blackberry, a lot of cherry in here. And flavors like that go really well with vegetable dishes. So this should be cooled off enough, Tom. Let me give you a little taste and see what you think.
Terrific.
Did those flavors blend? The basil, the parsley, the garlic, the tomato, eggplant. Well, I'm glad you like it.
Delicious.
I'm Barbara Seelig Brown. This is Tom Beyer. We want to thank you so much for joining us today on Stress Free Cooking. You can find us on Facebook at Stress Free Cooking with host Barbara Seelig Brown, on Instagram at Stress Free Cook. We have a website with the recipes, stressfreecooking.com. We wish you health, happiness, and wonderful, delicious dishes.
Salute.
Sellers was founded in 1973 by Jack and Dolores Cakebread. Now the second generation of Cakebreads are running the winery. Cakebread has been known for its unparalleled wines and its gracious hospitality.
Mainly in the Napa Valley and the North Coast, you can visit the winery or watch for Cakebread events in your area. With an enduring commitment to quality, the belief that life's occasions are elevated by good people, good food, and good wine flows through everything they do.
The Cakebreads take great pride in sharing their family with our families.